الحمد لله وكفى ثم الصلاة والسلام على عباده الذين اصطفى وبعد. We are living in the deceiving times, the deceiving eras, which the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam spoke about in the hadith that is narrated by Ibn Majah in his Sunan and greater authentic by our noble scholar al-Sheikh al-Albani rahimahullahu ta'ala, from the narrations of Abu Huraira radiyallahu anhu, who said that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Sayati ala nasi sanawatun khada'at." He said, "There shall come to the people some deceiving times, some deceiving eras. Yusaddaqu fiha al-kadhib, in which the liar will be considered truthful. Wa yukadhabu fiha as-sadiq, and the truthful one will be considered the liar. Wa yukhawwanu fiha al-amin, and the trustworthy will be considered a betrayer. Wa yu'tamanu fiha al-kha'in, and the betrayer will be considered the trustworthy. وَيَنْطِقُ فِيهَا الرُّوَيْبِضُ, and the riffraff will run their mouth in public affairs. قِيلَ يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ, it is said, O Messenger of Allah, مَا الرُّوَيْبِضُ, who are the رُوَيْبِضُ? And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, الرَّجُلُ التَّافِهِ يَنْطِقُ فِي أَمْرٍ عَامًّا, it is the scorned, degraded person who runs his mouth in public affairs. And this is the era that we are living right now. Every Tom and Jerry runs his mouth. This is the era that we are living right now, because the one who comes to the people with the treasure of Qala Allah, Qala Rasulullah, Qala Sahaba, this is what Allah said, this is what his prophet said, and this is what his companion said. The people accused those individuals of lying, and they accused them of betrayal simply because what they said disagrees with their desires. But the one who will come to them with the trash of the opinion of men, they are the ones whom the people uphold, and they are the ones whom the people appraise, and they consider them to be the truthful and the trustworthy simply because what they are saying agrees with their desire and their emotions. And the intelligent believer must be an anticipator of his intellect and reason, and a procrastinator of his desire and emotions. Because our desire and our emotions is what drag us to our port of destruction. People are reacting based on their desire and their emotions. This is the reason why we see people burning down houses, burning down police stations, burning down businesses, because their emotions are hurt. Yes, each and every one of us, our emotions are hurt, because the way this man was killed, the way George Floyd was killed, it's not right. A dog is not supposed to be killed in this manner. This is absolutely wrong, and it hurts the heart of whoever witnessed this video. It causes your heart to tremble, and it causes your eyes to shed tears, because this is absolutely wrong. However, the intelligent believer will react based on his reason, because he knows that burning down houses and businesses is not gonna make things better. It's only making things worse, and we're adding fuel to the fire. There's no benefit in that. This is the reason why even in the battlefield, our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, even if you are on a battlefield fighting with your enemy, you should not cut down trees. You should not burn houses. You should not destroy properties, because doing that will not bring any benefit. So we ask Allah the Almighty to grant us understanding of this deen. Ameen. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam also said in the hadith that is narrated by Abu Musa al-Ash'ari radiyallahu anhu, when they were with the companions of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam one day, he said, we were in the presence of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam one day for dhikr al-haraj, and the Prophet mentioned a pandemonium that shall come to pass. فَقُلْنَا يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ مَا الْحَرَجِ, so we said, O Messenger of Allah, what is this pandemonium that shall come to pass? And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, al-qatlu al-qatl, it is going to be killing, senseless killing and massacre. Hatta yaqtula ar-rajulu akha, وَعَمَّ وَابْنَ عَمِّ, to the point that a man will kill his own brother and his own uncle and his own cousin. We said, يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ وَمَعَنَا يَوْمَئِذٍ أُقُولُنَا. We said, O Messenger of Allah, are we in our senses when we will do this on that day? The Prophet said, تُنْزَعُ أُقُولُ أَكْثَرِ أَهْلِ ذَلِكَ الزَّمَانِ وَيَخْلِفُهُمْ هَبَاءٌ مِّنَ النَّاسِ يَحْسِبُ أَوْ يَحْسَبُ أَحَدُهُمْ أَنَّهُ عَلَى شَيْءٍ وَلَيْسَ عَلَى شَيْءٍ. The Prophet said, the intellect and the senses of the majority of the people of that time will be snatched away from them, and they will be led by riffraff, ragtag gangs, the association of criminals, whom one of them will think that he is upon something when in reality he is upon nothing. And this is what we see today, senseless killing. I mean, I'm talking about from the thugs in the hood who are killing their own brothers and sisters by drive-by shooting and more, to the police who were supposed to protect the civilians, to the leaders, like it happened with the Emir of Saudi, who killed that innocent man in the Saudi embassy in Turkey. All these senseless killing that is happening, and what happened, what we witness in Syria, in Libya, in Iraq, to the end, people are killing their own family. We ask Allah the Almighty to protect us from that. Ameen. So this is the reality that we see today, and it's very important for us to be careful of whom we take from, and to be careful of what we say, because this is a time of fitna. And if you don't pay attention, you will end up deviating from the path. Because He, the Most High, mentioned in the Quran, وَلَكِنَّ أَكْثَرُ النَّاسِ لَا يَعْقِلُونَ, the majority of the people have no sense, meaning they don't utilize their senses. وَلَكِنَّ أَكْثَرُ النَّاسِ لَا يَعْقِلُونَ. So do not follow the masses of the people, because the masses of the people follow their emotions and their desires. Rather, make sure that you listen to those who said, call Allah. This is what Allah said. This is what the messenger said. And this is how you will be safe and secure. Because sometimes some people claim that they know, when in reality they do not know. And this is the problem that we are facing nowadays. Some people take some portion of the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and they use it as a proof to instigate people to go out there. But the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the one who commanded us to change evil and to help the oppressor, he is the same one who passed by the family of Ammar when they were being tortured. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam would say to them, "Sabran ala Yasir fa inna maw'idakum al-jannah." Be patient, O family of Yasir, for indeed your abode is Jannah. This is not because the Prophet is pleased with the oppression that is going on. The Prophet did not tell his companions, go out there and fight for justice. No, Islam is a religion of order. Islam is an organized religion. If there is a change like this, it has to be an institutional change. This is the reason why the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was very patient while they were in Mecca, because they don't have authority until when they migrated to Medina and there is an Islamic state. This is when they were able to change with power. But right now, we don't have that power. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam commanded his companions to be patient, just as Musa alayhi salatu wasallam commanded his people to be patient. When they came to Musa and they cried to Musa after Fir'aun started to chop off their hands, and Fir'aun started killing the men, Musa, they said to Musa, "Udhina min qabli an ta'tiyana wa min ba'di ma ji'tana." O Musa, indeed, we've been harmed before you came to us. Our male were being killed. And after you came to us, we are still being harmed. Musa said to his people, "Ya qawm, ista'inu billahi wasbiru." O my people, seek the help of Allah the Almighty and be patient. Inna al-ardha لِلَّهِ يُورِثُهَا مَنْ يَشَاءُ مِنْ عِبَادِ. Indeed, the earth belongs to Allah the Almighty. He inherits it to whom He will. وَالْعَاكِبَةُ لِلْمُتَّقِينَ. And the good end is always for those who keep their duty to Allah the Almighty. Believe me, oppression will never last. This is why Fir'aun failed at the end. And Allah the Almighty inherited the land to the children of Israel. Why? Because of their patience. After being oppressed for centuries, decades, at the end, He, the Most High, said, وَأَوْرَثْنَا الْقَوْمَ الَّذِينَ كَانُوا يُسْتَضْعَفُونَ مَشَارِقَ الْأَرْضِ وَمَغَارِبَهَا الَّتِي كَانُوا وَمَغَارِبَهَا الَّتِي بَارَكْنَا فِيهَا. And we have inherited the land to those who were being oppressed, the weak who were being oppressed. We inherited the east and the west of the land and gave it to them. Why? Because of their patience. وَتَمَّتْ كَلِمَةُ رَبِّكَ الْحُسْنَ عَلَى بَنِي إِسْرَائِيلَ بِمَا صَبَرُوا. And the word of your Lord, meaning the promise of your Lord, which He promised the children of Israel, has been fulfilled. Why? Because of their patience. So we need to follow the guidance of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Our scholars said, إِذَا نَهَيْتَ عَن مُنْكِرٍ. If you want to prevent an existing evil, وَتَرَتَّبَ نَهْيُكَ عَن مُنْكِرٍ مُنْكِرٌ أَكْبَرُ مِن مُنْكِرٍ فَنَهْيُكَ عَن مُنْكِرٍ إِي مُنْكِرٌ. However, the method that you have taken towards preventing and eradicating that existing evil leads to another evil that is worse than the existing evil, then that method of yours is also evil. So how come you said you want to change the injustice that is going on? But the method that you are taking by itself is an injustice, and it leads to a greater injustice. Many people died in this. We ask Allah the Almighty to grant us understanding of this deen, ameen, and make us amongst those who listen and follow the guidance of the Prophet. Because wallahi, if we did not follow the guidance of the Prophet, we will drag ourselves to our port of destruction. Because the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, لَقَدْ تَرَكْتُكُمْ عَلَى مَحَجَّةٍ بَيْضَوْا. Indeed, I have left you upon a crystal clear path. لَيْلُهَا كَنَهَارِهَا. It's night. It's as bright as its day. لَا يَزِيغُ عَنْهَا إِلَّا هَالِكُ. None deviates from that path except the one who put himself into destruction. And this is what happened in Iraq. This is what happened in Syria. This is what happened in Libya. When the people rebelled against their leaders, and the scholars are telling them, do not rebel. Do not go out there and protest. But they did it. And guess what? Now they have regretted. Why? Because they have accused the scholars of being betrayers. And they accused them of being agents of the leaders. So as a result, now they are living in an ongoing chaos. May the Almighty make us amongst the intelligent people who are anticipators of their intellect and reason, and procrastinators of their desire and emotions. Ameen. Wa jazakumullahu khayran. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.